Hello there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Joining us once again from Cordiant Capital is Benn Mikula. A warm welcome to you discussing the Cordiant Digital Infrastructure Trust that you just launched last time we met. So we're going to understand what you've been up to in the last year or so, and crucially talking about that opportunity in the market as well. So Benn, great to see you. How have you been?
Very well, thank you. And a good morning to you, Katie. It's a great pleasure to be here today.
Well, it's a pleasure to have you. So how busy have you been in the last year or so, and how's it been going?
Well, we've been rather busy. Over the past year, we've raised just under £800 million in a series of fundraisings for Cordiant Digital. And we've deployed that capital in a series of strategic platforms in companies that enable the very functioning of the internet, the companies that allow your broadband mobile at home or your mobile telephone to function. Those companies, ranging from one of the most interconnected data centers in New York to a national champion network in the Czech Republic, are generating slightly under £100 million of cash flow on a pro forma basis. And the performance of the portfolio has somewhat exceeded the expectations we set out at the time of the IPO. We've generated a slightly over 10% total return for shareholders. And we continue to be very active. This is the third largest infrastructure market on the planet. If you look at numbers out of the consultancy McKinsey, over $600 billion a year are deployed in capital expenditures and digital to make things such as this video call function. So it's a vast market. Only roads and energy are larger than digital infrastructure. So there's lots to do. There's lots of requirements. The rather tragic COVID pandemic have revealed to us there are new ways of working and organizing our lives, and we expect those trends to continue. And we're investing very much at the forefront of that. We call it the plumbing of the internet, which makes it sound unglamorous, but these really are the long-lived assets, the mobile towers, the fiber optic, the data centers that are critical to the companies that provide our viewers today with the services that they use so frequently.
Mm-hmm. And you recently published some results, Benn, as well?
Yes, we did. The company has a net asset value per ordinary share that we've reported of 106.34 for the first year that we've been in operation, the first 11 months, in fact. And the diluted earnings per ordinary share were just a snick under 12.5 pence. The growth that we've achieved over the past year was not driven by excessive markups of assets. A very significant part of it was driven by free cash flow generation at these platforms, which was used to repay debt and increase equity value. And the reason I mention this, and it may interest the viewers, is that these digital assets, that these platforms that we're investing in, are not absolutely, they're not only absolutely critical to the functioning of the communications networks, but they can also generate very nice cash returns. And so one of the most pleasing things over the past year is we gave initial guidance that we would target at the end of the first year a 1p dividend, and we're already giving guidance that next year's dividend will be at 4p. So the stability of this diversified portfolio that we've assembled is such that we've significantly accelerated the dividend guidance and dividend payments.
Okay. And you mentioned the pandemic there, of course, and I remember talking about this last time. So I just want to talk about it now, because obviously the dynamics have changed. And at the time, during the lockdown situation, internet traffic was at unprecedented levels. How are you seeing that change impact you now? I'm interested to know.
Well, we had a series of spikes that happened over the course of the pandemic for reasons that will be obvious to all the viewers. But what's happened as things have normalized, as things have gone back to their more habitual pattern, is that the growth in traffic has returned to that sort of 10% level, which, you know, there are a great many segments in digital. And so it's very hard to generalize, because I will repeat, this is a vast market. But we saw year-on-year growth in some segments that had exceeded 40 or 45%, and that settled down. But the continued growth is going to remain strong. It will be unabated. And I think that was present before the pandemic, and perhaps the pandemic has set a new and higher base for that growth to expand from, but we don't see any change over the next 5 to 10 years in the ongoing importance of the digital economy.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you very much indeed for your time again today. That's Benn Mikula here on Proactive London.
Thank you so much, Katie.